When you're selling or promoting a digital product online, but you don't necessarily have product photography to rely on, one of the most important things you can do is to help make your product and its benefits feel real for your audience. And this can be a little tricky when your product only exists in a digital format. This is where combining simple mockups and animation can be so powerful. It helps you take something intangible and bring it to life visually, not just communicating its value, but also building excitement and making your audience feel like they're getting something tangible and real. So today I'm going to show you how to create a digital video animation template to help bring your digital products to life using just Canva. Plus, if you stick around till the end, I'm going to share four ways that you can customize this template quickly and easily to work for your brand. Of course, the first thing you need to help bring digital products to life are some screen grabs or visuals of the product content itself. And this can obviously be some pages of an ebook, or it could be some screen grabs of your online course content or a template you're selling, or even a scrolling video of a website. And in fact, in one of my previous videos, I showed you one simple way to create one of those scrolling animations using a screen recording. And I'll link to that up above and in the description below the video. But once you have those grabs, how do you present them in a way that's engaging and interesting and on brand? Let me walk you through how I created a digital video template that I can use going forward to promote my digital products. I'm just using a vertical format video design in Canva, and I've changed the background to match my brand colors. The first thing I did was look in the Canva library for an iPad frame, and I came across this one. Now, this one is in a slightly different proportion to a normal tablet, but what's great about this is the format is the same size as a horizontal video format, so it's easy to drop in screen grabs, video, etc. So I'm going to work with this one. The next thing I did was just add a simple frame in Canva, just so that I can drop placeholders into it or any other image or video that I want to. Then I put a placeholder image into that frame, and I've actually created a number of placeholders so that it's easy for me to see what image needs to go where once I start replacing those. You could, of course, immediately put in your image here. I'm just using placeholders so that you can see how it's easy to create something that could be reused as a template. Next, I just duplicated those elements and changed the images in the placeholders. So ultimately, I'm going to have four different things that are going to be showcased in this video. Then I just aligned those, and I did that by clicking on the frame and the image, going to position, arrange, and then using middle and center to align those two items. And then I'm just going to group them. And I did that for all four of these. So this is now a group, which means that when you look at the layers tab, you'll see that there are just four items essentially that I'm going to be animating. And that's basically all the preparation done. Now, the reason I do that as a kind of separate series of slides is because that way I can combine things, I can group them, play around with them, put the right images in, change colors, etc. And then I have the correct formatted items to start animating. And it just makes it a bit easier for me because then I'm working with almost finished items rather than trying to do things on the fly as I'm also animating them. Next, I just put in this black slide, and that's just to show me visually in the timeline where my real video or the actual video animation template will begin. I started with a very short 0.5 seconds empty screen, and the only reason I did that is because I want the first thing that people see is this object to animate in. And the way I've done that is by doing a transition between these two slides. On the next slide, I put in my frame with my placeholder number one in, and between the two, I've put in a transition, which is this chop transition. Now, I really like this transition because it draws attention immediately. You've got a few options by showing the kind of origin of where it comes from, and you can change the direction and the speed. But I just like the fact that going from an empty screen, people will immediately see this quick movement of something rotating onto the screen, and that's how the animation will begin. On the next slide, all I did was make that a little bit smaller and move it to the left-hand side. Then I duplicated that slide and I moved it to the right-hand side. Then I duplicated that slide again and I just enlarged the whole thing and made it center to the page. Then I duplicated that slide and I just moved the whole object down to allow a little space for text. Now that's the reason that I've had these two on the left and on the right of these slides, is so that we have some space to add text later on. Now once I've done this initial few slides, I then add a match and move transition between each of them. And because I'm using the exact same element, it then adds in those animation frames between the two slides. So as I play through, although the timing may not be right, this is what it looks like now. The object comes in with a transition, and then the match and move animation fills in those frames as it moves to the left, moves to the right, and then it resizes and comes to the center, and then moves slightly down to allow space for the text. So all of that is just done by adding that match and move transition between those slides, nice and easy. I duplicated the slide again and moved that placeholder one group up to the left and made it slightly smaller. And then I brought in placeholders two and three, the groups that I created in my working slides at the beginning of this file. And you'll see that's how they're going to end up, but I want them to animate in. Because they're not on the previous slide, I'm not going to add a match and move to move them in. The match and move is just going to move that one object from that previous slide, making it smaller and moving it to the left. These two items I actually want to animate in a different way. I'm going to do that by using one of Canva's brand new animations. I'm going to go to position and I'm going to click on this placeholder number two group. Now, the reason I'm selecting them in the side panel with the layers is because they're a group. Sometimes if you click on them, it doesn't select the whole group. So I want to make sure that it's the group that's selected and not one part of the group. Now I'm going to go to animate and I'm going to use this brand new animation that Canva has created called Succession. Now Succession, I don't know why it's called that, but what it does basically is anything that you add the succession animation to will grow from small to big to the size that you want it to be. And it will also go from blurry, from soft focus, clear into focus at the same time. So I'm going to click on succession for that one, and I'm going to do it for the next one. So now you'll see if I click and drag the playhead, that's what match and move creates. And then these two items animate in using that succession animation, the brand new one. And the timing is just adjusted by clicking on it, making sure you've selected the group, then clicking on the three dots or right clicking to show timing. And you can see I've dragged the handle from the left a little bit in, so it doesn't come in immediately as the slide starts. It comes in a little later. And then once that one is in, I then have the next one animating in, and you can see how where they start changes, and I can click and drag that to adjust. Next, I duplicated this slide and resized and rearranged these items. And for this, I left space underneath because I'm going to have text boxes in here underneath them to showcase some of the features or to highlight the benefits of whatever this product could be. Now, obviously, we use match and move transitions between slides a lot because they create that really smooth animation of elements. But if you're not necessarily going to use all the same elements, you don't have to use match and move. There are many other transitions between slides that create some really nice effects, especially when you want to change things up to make sure you're keeping people's attention. So on the next slide, I have these three items, which I've placed on this slide. And then I've also brought in placeholder number four, and I've just arranged them in this kind of grid pattern. And what I've done is the top three are all grouped as one group, and the bottom three are grouped as one group. So if I go to position, you'll see that there are just two items or two groups. And that's because I want these to animate by moving slightly left and right, almost like they're scrolling across the page. And I do that by clicking on the group, making sure that I have the whole group selected, and then going to animation and using the drift animation. And you can change the direction so that they move in different directions, and you can change the intensity so that the speed is a little bit variable. You don't have much control over those, but they do help just to get the effect that you want. So I've done that on the top group and on the bottom group and have them moving in different directions. So you'll see that the transition between the slides gives those four color bars, which you can customize in the left-hand panel here to suit your brand colors or anything else that you want. And then it moves on to this next slide where we have these two groups that slowly move using that drift animation. And because I'm not using match and move, I don't have to worry about them being the exact same frames or slides. I've incorporated a new one and that works fine. Next, I've used a different transition again, and this one is called the flow transition. And what that does is that it moves the items from the slide you're going to into the slide that you're on now. And they're all starting at slightly different times and moving at slightly different speeds. So there's kind of a staggered effect of them all flowing onto the screen. And you'll see what I mean here. So on this slide, I have a placeholder group for three and four, but I also have a block in the background that has a slightly different color background. And that's because I wanted that kind of wipe effect. So if we go back here and I click and drag the playhead, you'll see that that flow animation moves the color background block as well as the two elements at slightly different speeds, but they all end at the same time on the page. And then I have also added a drift animation to these groups so that they move slightly once they have entered the page. So we'll play through and you can see there's the transition and then they drift slightly. Now I'm going to use these two items on the next page. So I just duplicated that slide and resized and moved them up and down to allow a bit of space here again for text. And I used match and move between them. So you can see there's just that nice drift animation and then the match and move transition moves them apart. Next, I've used the flow animation again. And all that's gonna do is just move the background of the next slide on because that's all I want initially to wipe across the screen. I could have used a color wipe there, but I decided to use flow just to keep it consistent. Next on this slide, I'm going to bring in these four groups, the four placeholder groups that I originally created. If I zoom out, you'll see that I've just aligned them diagonally across the page. And what I want them to do is actually come in really sharply. So I'm not using any animation or transitions. All that's going to happen is that the timing of these groups is adjusted so that each one comes in a slightly staggered way. So you'll see that one is the last one, the one before it is a little earlier, the next one a little earlier, and the first one even earlier. And because they're coming in really sharply, this will be great if you can adjust it to the beat of the music once you add some music or sound effects, and it creates a really lovely effect with these kind of sharp transitions, which again is a little different from all the smooth transitions we've had up till now, so it helps to keep attention. So this is how it looks if we play through from that previous slide, using the flow transition and then these very sharp appearances of the four elements. Then I duplicated this slide with the four elements on, but what I did was move them off the page. Then I put in the match and move transition. And so if I click and drag, you can see how they go from this slide where the four of them have appeared. They then use match and move transition to move off the page in the four different directions, leaving us with a blank page, which then transitions to one of the darker final slides. The slide transition is a circle wipe, and then I've used that same succession animation to bring in my logo, which means it enlarges as well as gets clearer from a soft focus to clear. And then for the next final slide, I used match and move just to move that logo up a little bit and make it smaller, again, to allow for some space for a final call to action on this last slide. Now, before we get into adding the text into this video, there are two things that I'd like to ask of you. The first is if you would be interested in having this template available to purchase in my store for you to download and use in Canva, please leave a comment and let me know if that would be something that would be interesting and useful for you, and I'll see if I can make that available as soon as possible. Secondly, if you're interested in learning more about how to use Canva to its full potential and use it like a professional designer would, then I'd love it if you would sign up to my weekly newsletter. It's called Meaningful Creations. It goes out just once a week, and I let you know what new tutorials are available, what free resources there are for you, and I also showcase different creators from all over the world while sharing a bit of my experience and my expertise. If you go to the link on the screen right now or in the description below the video, you can sign up. And as I say, that goes out once a week, and I'd love to see you there. As we're now just adding text and I don't need to refer to those original groupings that I created, I've just deleted the working slides from the front of this video. So we now start with that plain slide with the transition of that element moving in. Now what I'm going to do is just go to the slides where I have space and add in some placeholder text. I've just added in a simple heading and then a few bullet points so that it's easy for me to customize these. And all I've done is use a blur transition to get them onto the page so that it's just very subtle, but it kind of reflects what we've done elsewhere in this video. On the next slide, of course, the text goes on the left-hand side, and I've adjusted the timing of the text so that it comes in a little bit after the transition has moved that image across. So it gives it a couple of seconds or split seconds before the text blurs in. Next, on this page, I've actually put some text behind this placeholder. And the reason I've done that is because on the following page, that placeholder moves down, and I wanted to reveal this text. So all I've done is used this text on this page, copied and pasted it on the previous page and made sure it's behind this placeholder. It doesn't need an animation. I just need to make sure that it comes in about halfway through so it's still hidden here. And that means that with the match and move transition, you'll see that when we go to the next slide, that moves down, revealing that text, which is a really great effect. On the next slide, again, I have some space for just a text box. And so I've put in a simple heading box, again, just using that blur animation and adjusting the timing I then copied and pasted the heading and bullet boxes from one of those first slides, and I used them underneath these three elements, again, so that this is very flexible. You can highlight benefits, you can highlight different options, and it just gives us a bit more space to add some extra content in. Next, I'm going to click and drag, and you'll see we go into that line wipe and then those drifting elements. Then we have the flow transition, and we just have a subtle drift on those two. And then when they separate, I decided I want to add some text in there as a kind of call to action. So I've added this lovely script text in there. Next, we have the slide that has those four very sharp entry points of the four elements. And then, of course, we just have the circle wipe that wipes out and the logo comes in. And then when the logo gets smaller and moves up on the final slide, I'm going to add a final bit of text in there. And I'm just going to copy and paste this script font text into here, and I'm going to change it to don't miss out. And that has a wipe transition on it. All I've got to do is click on the three dots, show timing, and make sure that I adjust it so it only comes in once that logo has got smaller. And so you'll see if I click and drag, the logo gets smaller and then the text comes in. And that's the end of our creation. Now, I know it's been quite quick talking you through this, but I just wanted to show you that actually, if you just work slide by slide and you prepare those elements at the beginning, it's quite easy to just copy and paste the same slide and then make tweaks to each one using Match and Move to create some interesting transitions and animations between them. But again, let me know if this would be helpful for you to be able to purchase as a template. But if not, do give it a go and try and create it for yourself. Now, I did promise if you stick around, we'd talk about four really quick and easy ways to customize this template to work for your brand. And this goes back to the basics of our brand, those key brand elements that I always talk about. First of all, just changing the colors in this presentation to your brand colors will immediately make a huge difference. And of course, the second thing is your brand fonts. Just changing those two things in this presentation would completely change the look and feel of it and make it more aligned with your brand. The other thing to remember is that if you're including background colors here, you could also include background textures or perhaps even slightly animated video backgrounds on these slides. If you have elements like that that you already use for your brand, or maybe you use a background that's a kind of dark wood instead of just a solid color, whatever works for your brand and will help you build consistency, you could just use in the background of these slides rather than a plain color like I have. See what works for you. But remember that you're trying to showcase the digital product. So that needs to really stick out. That needs to shine. And then the last way that you can really customize these to make them your own is on those slides where we have the elements that are now moving because of the match and move transition and the animations we've included. You could add in some elements that represent your brand. So for example, if your brand has a much more illustrative style and you use lots of hand-drawn elements or illustrations, you could add those onto some of these slides, having these mock-ups moving over them or even having them animate themselves. Canva has a huge library of animated elements that you could bring in depending on what works for your brand. The big thing is consistency with the rest of your materials and, as I mentioned, making sure that the elements within those placeholder frames still shine. Now, the last thing that I would do for any video like this is to add some music. You could pull from Canva's music library or find your own from either one of the paid or free music libraries that are available online, and then just adjust your timing slightly so that it works with the music. And just with a couple of tweaks, you're left with something that is incredibly powerful. That's it. There you go, folks. I hope this has been helpful. I so appreciate you being here. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Let me know if you'd like this template available. And of course, please sign up to my weekly newsletter, and I will see you soon. Have a fabulous week.